guys. Today, here I am in my backyard, and I am going to read to you a story that I am really fond of, and it is called The Important Book. And The Important Book is a series of poems about some things that you would encounter every day in life, and what is important about them. This story was written by Margaret Wise Brown, and you may know her from a book that probably many of you have heard called Goodnight Moon. And the pictures are by Leonard Weisgard. The Important Book. Ooh, here's something I never noticed before. It's the title page. And right here on the title page of the book, it says, "The important thing about glass is you can see through it." I would agree. That is an important thing about glass. Helps us to have windows, glasses, so many other things. Here we go. "The important thing about a spoon is that you eat with it. It's like a little shovel. You hold it in your hand. You can put it in your mouth. It isn't flat. It's hollow. And it spoons things up. But the important thing about a spoon is that you eat with it." "The important thing about a daisy is that it is white. It is yellow in the middle. It has long white petals, and bees sit on it. It has a ticklish smell. It grows in green fields, and there are always lots of daisies. But the important thing about a daisy is that it is white." "The important thing about rain is that it is wet. It falls out of the sky, and it sounds like rain, and makes things shiny. And it does not taste like anything, and is the color of air. But the important thing about rain is that it is wet." "The important thing about grass is that it is green. It grows and is tender with a sweet grassy smell. But the important thing about grass is that it is green." "The important thing about snow is that it is white. It is cold and light and falls softly out of the sky. It is bright and the shape of tiny stars and crystals. It is always cold and it melts. But the important thing about the snow is that it is white." "The important thing about an apple is that it is round. It is red. You bite it, and it is white inside. And the juices splash in your face. And it tastes like an apple. And it falls off a tree. But the important thing about an apple is that it is round." "The important thing about the wind is that it blows. You can't see it, but you can feel it on your cheek. And see it bend trees and blow hats away, and sailboats. But the important thing about the wind is that it blows." "The important thing about the sky is that it is always there. It is true that it is blue and high and full of clouds and made of air. But the important thing about the sky is it is always there." "The important thing about a shoe is that you put your foot in it. You walk in it, and you can take it off at night. And it's warm when you take it off. But the important thing about a shoe is that you put your foot in it." "The important thing about you is that you are you. It is true that you were a baby and you grew, and now you are a child, and you will grow into a man or into a woman. But the important thing about you is that you are you. That is the end of that story. And I just think there are such sweet little poems and nuggets in those stories. And now I want to challenge you to write an important poem about something that you're thinking about. So a little earlier today, I was in my reading spot in my backyard, and I read the important book to you guys. And now I have come to my quiet workspace, which is our classroom at school. And I took some time to write my very own important things poem. So the first thing I did, my process for writing, was to brainstorm, which means to think of some things that are important to me. And so I came up with a list, and I put six different things on my list. On my list, I have toys, books, pizza, trees, family, water, vacation, and popsicles. And all of those things are important to me, and there's so many more things that are important to me, but this was the list I came up with in my brainstorm this afternoon. So after I brainstormed some important things, I started to think about why those things were important to me. So off to the side right next to them, I wrote some ideas about why those things were important. So you can kind of see some of my ideas. Some things I had more ideas about why they were important, and some things I only thought of less things. Some things there are more things inside my head, and I just wrote down a few. So after that, I put a gold star next to the one I wanted to write a poem about. And I decided to write my poem about books, because I thought of so many reasons why books are important to me. So after that, I took that template that I emailed it to your family. So you can take your template about important things, and you can start to write your important things poem. So I wanted to share with you my important things poem. It's called Books. The important thing about a book is it tells stories. It has pictures and words. It can take you to new places and teach you new things. Sometimes they make you laugh, and sometimes they make you cry. They have pages to turn and a special smell when they are new. But the important thing about a book is it tells stories. So that was my important things book, and it really helped me that I was able to do my brainstorm first, because some of the things that I wrote down on my brainstorm, I was able to include in my poem. So for books, I said they tell stories, they have pages, they make you laugh. So those were just a few things that I had written down on my brainstorm. And then when it came time for me to write my rough draft and then my final draft of my poem, I included even more details. So finally, the last step was an illustration for my picture. And I thought that I could draw a picture of books, but instead I decided to take a picture of myself with some books. So here's my picture of me in our classroom library with the Important Thing book and so many other really, really great books. So this is kind of neat because it could be the start of my very own Important Things book. When you write your Important Things poem and have your illustration, whether it's a photograph of you with your important thing or if you draw a picture of it, make sure you send it to me, because then I can put it together into a book that we can have for our class, and you can also have it for your class once you get to third grade. So get to writing. I just can't wait to see what you come up with. Have fun.